Super Mutant Alien Assault.
We are all about the attacking and the fighting.
Such a good name.
Yeah, very aggressive. It's all about the little robots there. Janitor robots just trying to go home. And a bunch of aliens have the other idea and they want to try and stop them. So super fast combat action platforming. Sorry.
Yeah, and it looks really retro and awesome. I love like the look and the feel of it.
Yeah, so it's made by a one-man team out of Sydney from Cybernaut, Chris. He's been working on it in his spare time and he's taking it up a notch. It's out now on Steam Early Access and he'll be coming to Xbox One and PS4 in about 2 months' time.
Chris, tell us a little bit about the soundtrack. I'm hearing it's really aggressive.
Yeah, so it's very much got that dubstep soundtrack to it. We have a saying in Australia called taking the piss, where it's like not too serious and the game definitely takes the piss out of itself. It's one of those games that'll kick your ass the first few times and then once you figure it out and get the hang of it, that's where the reward comes in. So every 8 levels is a boss fight and they'll definitely kick your ass the first few times, but then once you figure out the patterns and how the boss works, that's where you'll be able to take it out.
So the main character is a badass robot. What's his story?
I wouldn't say he's badass, he's a janitor robot. So combat is definitely not his primary job. But yeah, he's figured out how to shoot a gun. Once he gets some of the bigger guns, like the shotgun, he flies back a little bit. But he's definitely got it in him to take out the aliens. We actually affectionately call it the Citizen Kane of Super Great Box clones. Super Great Box is a game that's very similar, but we took a more like space approach to it. And yeah, 8-bit is definitely an inspiration for it, as it is for a lot of indie titles. And yeah, we love that art style, so that's the one that we went with. These shows are great. We get a lot of feedback, and we take a lot of notes and listen to fan feedback as well. So we're able to kind of implement that. And because it's a small team, we can implement those changes very fast.
Wow, so what kind of fan feedback have you been getting and have you been taking any of those notes into consideration?
Yeah, so the first time we showed it, we found that the sniper rifle was actually a bit overpowered. So we went back to the drawing board with the sniper rifle and changed it up a bit. Originally people were using it like a shotgun and because it's so powerful, it takes out most enemies in one shot. So what we did was we made it a little bit longer and took out the ability for people to use it in close range. So now you've got to actually be at a distance to shoot it, so it just balances it out like that.
So can we go into a little bit of detail about the different types of weapons you have in the game?
Yeah, so you got like the basic shotgun and M16, but then we've taken a bit of a creative liberal approach to it. So we've got a pogo stick, a jetpack, which like you fly in the air and then the flames of the jetpack will incinerate people below. We've got a handgun, which is really powerful and makes them fly across the screen every time he shoots it. Sniper rifle, a jet engine, which pushes him back and shoots out flames as he uses it, and then a bunch of other alien weapons as well, and an AK-47, because you've got to have an AK.
So is the pogo stick a weapon?
Yeah, basically you jump around the map on it, and then when you want to kill someone, you just jump a little bit higher, and then you land on them, and they explode.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
That sounds like a really awful way to die. Death by pogo stick?
But
that might be the worst weapon.
Yeah, when you're a cleaning robot in space, and that's all you got, you gotta make do. Yeah, so it's out in early access on Steam at the moment and it'll be coming to Xbox One and PlayStation 4 later on in the year.
Cool. Well, do you have any tips for any beginners like me that'd be playing this game?
Yeah. Read the instructions and stay away and keep the distance between the aliens.
Read the instructions. Yeah. I love that. We're just keeping it basic, guys.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you so much, James.
No worries. Thank you.
Thanks for tuning in to ConTV.